Buongiorno, paisani. I'm John Viola.
And I'm Rossella Rago, and we are coming to you from the San Gennaro Feast on Mulberry Street for an exciting new project between the Italian-American podcast and the Italian Sons and Daughters in America.
That's right. Every month, we are going to take you across this great country of ours to explore the Italian side of America. Myself, Ro, our other co-hosts, we spend a lot of time in the Italian-American community, and we think there's so much that you're going to want to see. So as we travel on our adventures, we're bringing you greetings from Italian America. And today we're starting here in the Little Italy of New York City at the Festa di San Gennaro. Ready to go?
I think it's time for Zeppoli.
Let's see.
Let's go.
If you're joining us for this magnificent feast of San Gennaro, known around here as La Festa Tutte Feste, the Feast of All Feasts, the first thing you need to know is that you're taking part in an Italian-American tradition of over 90 years. Each year, the streets of this iconic neighborhood come to life for an 11-day celebration of faith and culture, consisting of games, music, and enough food to feed an army.
This could save starving children.
Yeah, this is it.
Sausage and peppers, meatballs, and a collection of some of the best desserts on the planet. And that's just the start. Bro and I are on a mission to try it all, including the fabled deep-fried rainbow cookie.
But I heard about it, and now I gotta have it.
Yeah, let's go.
Dozens of restaurants, both old and new, contribute to this literal feast. Newer residents are happy to join in such a storied celebration, while neighborhood originals, now run by second and third generation family members, return to the neighborhood with pride.
This is the most famous sausage and pepper in America.
No matter the background, the goal is the same: to welcome and provide visitors with the meal of a lifetime.
Tricolor cookies.
Oh my god, deep fried rainbow cookies sounds like a thing.
We gotta get some torrone.
Oh, torrone is a must. Torrone.
The food here is great, and like I said, there's plenty of it. But to truly understand what we're really celebrating here, it's important to go back all the way to the 4th century in Naples, Italy, during a time of rampant Christian persecution. Gennaro, the Bishop of Benevento, and now the patron saint of Naples, had tried to intercede for the release of a local deacon who was being held prisoner. Gennaro's attempts, however, were met with great resistance, and he too was arrested and later beheaded. Samples of his blood were collected by the faithful and stored in special glass vials, known as amipals, where they periodically liquefy, a miracle that occurs around 3 times each year. His feast day, celebrated each year on September 19th, observes the anniversary of his martyrdom, celebrates this fascinating miracle. The feast officially made its American debut on September 19th, 1926, right here in Little Italy. Newly arrived Italian immigrants, many from Naples, gathered along Mulberry Street for what has since become the quintessential staple in the Italian-American feast calendar. And nearly 100 years later, the tradition is still alive and well, proudly observed by Italians and Catholics all over the world. Although, personally, I think we do it best right here in New York. A slight break from the avalanche of calories to visit my friend, Mr. Ernie Rossi, owner of a store that sells, well, just about every little thing that an Italian-American would need but can't find anywhere else.
Oh my god, this is like the Italian nonna's basement of my dreams.
Yeah.
Though it now sits a few feet away from its original storefront, this place remains a living, breathing, Italian-American heirloom. It was opened in 1910 by Ernie's grandfather, Ernesto, and the majority of its early years were spent as a music store and a music publishing company.
Really, it was a music publishing house from 1920s and 30s on the E. Rossi and Company.
It may now be more of a holy grail of Italian gifts and novelties, but the store retains much of its original magic and allure.
When you're here, you are home. There's everything that we grew up with here. There's nothing, when you come in here, you can't say, oh my God, I had that with my grandmother. I want to use it again because Ernie will go, oh, we got them. Here they are.
You love this stuff, don't you?
My first job in the store as a kid was putting key rings on these things. These are cornea horns.
Ernie, why do you still do this? I mean, why do you keep this place even though the neighborhood has changed? What makes you keep going?
Well, I was born and raised here. And it's home to me.
Right.
And you never know who's going to walk in that door. You just walked in. You don't know who's going to walk in every day. So every day, yeah, it could be a quiet day, and all of a sudden someone walks in and changes the whole mood of the day. You know?
Mr. Rossi's store is the perfect symbol of defiance in a changing and less appreciative world, a most welcome dose of authentic Italian America, and a reminder that the true spirit of Little Italy lives on. Okay, it had amazingly been about a whole hour since we last ate, and we still had a few places to hit. The good news was, we'd finally tracked down those deep-fried rainbow cookies.
The fried rainbow cookies of the San Gennaro Feast.
This is not an urban legend. They exist.
They're real.
They're red, white, and green, and they look beautiful. Let's see how they taste.
Bad news? They were just a little too sweet.
Wow.
That is very sweet.
Wow.
So, we stopped by La Bella Ferrata and learned about another take on the popular tricolor cookie.
You know how they make the rainbow cookies?
Yes.
When they slice them, they get exposed to air, so they dry up. So we dipped it, turned it into a donut, and dipped it in chocolate, and it stays moist on the inside.
The end result? Perfecto.
That's much better.
Oh, my God.
That's way better.
Yeah. Amazing. Best thing at the feast.
Before we could bring our day to a close, we managed to have a few more Italian-American classics. Pasta ciotti from Cafe Roma, and cannolis from Ferrara's Bakery.
Perfect.
Then, it was off to church for a high mass in honor of our beloved patron saint. Most Precious Blood Church, opened in 1891, is considered by many to be the heart and soul of Little Italy. The church is officially the only national shrine to San Gennaro, and the place we gather to celebrate the most central theme of this wonderful feast, our faith. It's a beautiful celebration, immediately followed by a procession through the old neighborhood. Amidst the serenade of brass and the cheers and hollers of the faithful, what it's all about. The ritual, the custom, the proper ingredients to a festival destined to live on and thrive for another 93 years, and then some. As most occasions do, these 11 days fly by. But the sounds, the smells, the tastes of a bygone era, they help build the memories we use to pass the torch of tradition on through the generations. And one day, we'll be the elders, sharing our stories of what it was like to view these festivities through our own youthful senses. And we'll smile, give a little nod, knowing that we've done our part to make this wonderful culture even brighter, simply by coming home.
guys, we had the best time today.
From all of us, the Italian American Podcast, here at the Festa Tutte Feste San Gennaro, we'll see you next time.
Ciao.
I can't anymore.
Far l'amore con te, you're all I dream of. Far l'amore con te is all I care to do. Far l'amore con te, every waking hour. Far l'amore con te. L'amore con te, I'll always, always love you.
Thank you.
Love it.
Woo-hoo!